not able to understand what I just said. That's why words are so important. Yes, today we can have so many signs, so many body languages and eye languages, but words bring real emotions out of us and help us communicate to people, isn't it? It's so important in a young person's life too, because words have the power to create. Words have the power also to destroy and to pull down things. So today, words are important. For a young person, what is the most importance they give for words? It's memes. That's the most important things words are useful for. They make every word of people, every word of a person or a big figure a joke. They make words a joke and comedy out of words. That's the main thing that they do. Meme called anti-Indian trending right now. They make fun of that word. But it's such a serious word, isn't it? But so many people are putting different kinds of jokes, so creative in doing so. But, you know, they'll only know how important words are when they are on the other end of the camera. It's all fun and games when you can play around with those words from your home. But you know, these words are so important, even among a husband and a wife. It gives the wife so much respect when a husband speaks her up in front of friends and family. When he says, she's so good and she takes care of everyone. Everyone, by those words, have so much respect for her. Same thing when he makes a joke of her saying, oh, she can't do that. Everyone's value of her drops. That's the same when among our friends, when we call someone nickname, hurtful nicknames, people, everyone, strangers even, and it crosses their school, their college career, and even in their life, people start branding them by that nickname. A clown, a comedy fellow, or a fat guy. That's how people see them lifelong, and they're so hurt by it, they cry. And we don't see that. We only see people laughing with us. Words can hurt. And there are people speaking negative words all the time. It's so annoying to be around such people, right? Maybe you have such a person in their family, in your family, or among your friends. If you do, comment below and tell us who that is and how annoying it is. They're always discouraging. They're always saying bad things about the family members. And it's so annoying that we think, why did we invite them for this function? Why did we invite them for this party? They're better to be left out. Yes, such people are left out many of the times. People who speak negativity. And these words come out of us in anger also, being so hurtful. We swear at people and we speak angry words and it hurts people. Oh, it really hurts their heart. One word can be a bad day, a totally destructive day for them. One word can kill a person even. And sharing these words. Many of us forward things in WhatsApp, but are you sure you're forwarding the right things about a person? We spread many false news about businesses, about people through WhatsApp. You are the one sharing to your circle. It's not someone else forwarding. It's you who is sharing to your next circle. So you are responsible for all the bad words that go out, for all the false news that go out from you. Oh, those words can hurt someone really bad and pull down their life. So you're the one finally responsible for making it happen. So check your facts before doing that. Check your facts about what words you're spreading out. Today, let's give these words to become creative, to pull people up. And the only way that can do that is through giving these words into God's hands. Every word that comes out from us. How does that happen? First, by us saying, Lord, my words have been bad. My words have been insulting. My words have been destructive. Forgive me and change my words. When you say that, God's Spirit will fill you from inside and He will start making you speak in a whole new language, in a language called tongues. It comes from God's Spirit. That language is a secret language where you experience so much joy, only just between you and God, and only God understands. Oh, 1 Corinthians 14:4 says, that language of God cleans you and edifies you, makes you a whole new person. After that, the words that come out of you, it's the language of God that you speak to people. Pure words, loving words, words which will heal them and lift them up, words which will encourage them, words which build, create, and not destroy. Shall we ask such words to come out of our mouth from this moment to God? Lord, right now, to all those people who want their words to create and build, Lord, fill them with your Spirit. Let your tongues come from within their heart, right into their tongue, into their lip, and let them speak God's language. Oh, let them speak right now, Lord, and that language, let it go out to people to build their lives, to create, and to create, Lord, goodness back into them, because they have spoken good words, the good words of God. In Jesus' name, amen. My friends, your words have become brand new, and it comes from a place of purity from this moment. Your words will create. So tell us right now how your words are being and how you want your words to become in the comment section. If you like this video, like it and share it to your friends so that they can also be touched by this. And I'll see you in the next video.
Hello friends from Hutton Club Raipur. We all wish you a very Merry Christmas!